is your head. Would you classify that as a pass?
Well, that depends.
On what?
On where your hand was when he was kissing.
Say, where was your hand?
It was on the end of my arm. He's always behaved like a perfect gentleman.
What's a perfect gentleman?
Well, is it my fault you never met one?
Hey, if he's kissing your hand all the time, maybe he's up to something.
But like what?
Your wristwatch.
The only thing he's after is inner contentment. And I'm gonna be the one who helps him find it.
Honey, you sure picked up a couple of $100 words since you've been hanging around with this goofball.
Hey, Oscar is not a goofball. Jeez, he's a highly complicated and a very intelligent person.
All right, so besides slobbering all over your knuckles, what else can he do?
He's in the tax and accountancy profession, and he's a graduate of CCNYU University.
Oh, sounds like a goofball to me.
What does the goofball think about your vocation?
He might, my what?
Your chosen field of endeavor, child. Does he know you're in the rent-a-body business?
Sure he does, and he thinks nothing of it.
She ain't told him.
In the first place, Oscar is far too highly educated to be bothered about things like that. And in the second place, he knows, because I already told him.
Did she ever dance all those days?
Yes, yes.
You told him?
Yes, I told him. I told him.
When?
Next Sunday. I'll tell him next Sunday in Coney Island.
She won't listen. The girl just won't listen.
Say, why do you think they talk about, you know, when they're alone?
Talk? That girl's good for everything but conversation.
Yeah, he probably does all the talking, handing her those lines like, baby, last night I dreamt about you and me in a cozy cottage covered with clinging vines.
And there they were, clinging closer than the vines.
And then he converts a convertible sofa and really goes to work.
Come to think of it.